Hello and welcome back to the channel. My name is Gerard and behind the camera is Helen, like last time. And I'm gonna explain to you why I didn't bought the cheapest BMW of the internet. Because who wanna drive a 46 with 200 or 300,000 miles on the odometer? I don't, I think you won't either. So I bought this one. It's an F31 2015 330 diesel xDrive. Why I bought a diesel? Well, that's because in Switzerland you pay the same taxes for a diesel as for a gasoline car. So it was obvious, and because I drive a lot of miles, I bought a diesel. So it's got 258 horsepower and it's got 560 newton meters of torque. So that's a lot. And I like it because you can drive the car like you drive a Porsche or something else. So it's a 2015 model. It's a Sportline edition. So it got some features the other car doesn't. It got the 18-inch rims. Those were standard on the car. It's got the LED in combination with the xenon headlights, so it got the angel eyes, and the regular edition doesn't got xenon or LEDs. And it's got a slightly different front bumper. I have to be honest, I bought a new one because the original one who was in it had chrome listings around the BMW kidneys or grill, how do you want to call it. So I changed it for a black grill because you could call it a shadow line, because all the trim on the car, like this trim, the trim here, this, everything is black. So I don't want chrome in the grill when I got the shadow line. So I changed it. It comes and it's got a black trim on the back as well. Black exhaust. I don't know if that's standard, but it came with it, so yeah, it's a bit dirty, but yeah, we are in a forest right now, so can't keep it clean here when it has rained for the last couple of days. It got the tinted windows, and I like tinted windows so people can't look in the back or in the trunk what you got in it, and if you drive at night, the lights of the cars behind you won't blind you in the mirrors, so that I like. You got the shark tail antenna, and that's basically it. So on the outside you got your mirrors, your indicator in the mirrors, and that's basically it on the outside. So we go to the inside of the car where you can see the listing. Oh, it shows BMW Sport. That's because it's the Sportline edition. It's got the sport seats. Can you call it bucket seats? I don't know. It's the BMW sport seats. It doesn't got leather seats inside of it because the person who owned it before me didn't buy it full option.
Well, it's not only that. It's also because normally we buy cars with a light interior, and this one we also bought because it didn't had leather interior.
Yeah, because to be honest, because I can get a bit sweaty in the summertime, and I will stick to the seats.
Yeah,
and I don't like that. So this is the first time in years that I bought a car without leather interior. I must be honest, to get in the car I had really get used to it, because like in the last video you've seen, I got a Nissan X-Trail as well, and that's a high car, so you can get in and out very easily. And before that I drove a 07 Volvo S80, and that's practically the same. That's easy to get in and out in. So I'm going to show you how to get in this car.
How you get in the car.
How I get in the car. And it's you practically fall inside of it, And I got the seat on the highest position. So if I lower the seat, it's ridiculous. I can't get in the car properly. So this is the inside of the car. You got your regular steering wheel here with the buttons on it. Yeah, you can do your cruise control. You can up and down the volume of your radio. It's got the DAB radio in it. And you got your lights here, obviously. I always drive on automatic, so you don't turn on your lights, it does it itself. You got a secret compartment here. I like it because I got a map where I got all my bank cards, health insurance cards, driver's license, papers of the car in it. It's like this big and it fits perfectly, and then you shut it and it's gone. So I like it. You got your buttons to open the tailgate. It's got an automatically opening tailgate. And the bonnet, and press it twice and it doesn't got a lock on it. So you have to open it, press it twice, and I can show you guys. Oh, there you go. Pull it twice. Pull it twice and it will open, and now you can just open it. And that's the engine. That's the 3-liter twin turbo diesel engine. And I really like the machine. It's BMW. Can't go wrong there. And close it again. And it's closed. About the key, you got some features. The people who drove a BMW already know some of the features. If you don't, I will show you. You got your 3 buttons on there. Got a little fly on my sweater. You got your unlock the doors, close the doors, and you got your open the trunk button. Now I'm gonna show you. It's summertime, it's very hot outside, and you been inside a supermarket to do some groceries, and you come outside and the car will be like a sauna inside. What you do, you got the unlock button, you're gonna press it and hold it, and all the windows will come down so the heat can go out of the car. Then you can, because you did some groceries, press the button and the trunk will open, so the air will go through the car. Now you have to hold it to close it again. The nice thing about the trunk is you can go into the menu of the car and adjust the height of the trunk opening, so that's really nice. And in my last video you could see I couldn't get underneath the trunk of my Nissan X-Trail. Now I'm gonna show you the trunk of my BMW 3 Series, which is a lot lower. And I can stand underneath it, and I'm 5'9". It's don't got a lot of space, but I can go underneath it. Yeah.
So I have the same height as you, so if I would wear heels, I would have problems with it.
Yeah, don't wear heels.
I don't, so that's
so
okay.
So we have the trunk, so I'm gonna show you the trunk. We go back inside the front afterwards. So you got your trunk. It's not a really big trunk. You can fold the back seats down and it's get a little bit bigger. You got here the holes inside. You can put a rack in it. There it is. And secure your luggage. No, I'm not gonna take it. You want me to take it out?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah?
I mean, if female watch this video, that are the things which are important to know.
Okay.
I mean, for guys it's perhaps not, but
so you got some luggage in it or groceries, and you don't want them to slide through the whole boot. Put this in it and it will hold your groceries, luggage, suitcases in place. Now you can pull this out, these cords, press the button, yeah. And if you got some if you got something small,
I can't.
You can't.
Ah, you have to keep pushing them.
Yeah.
That's why it didn't work.
And then
Ah, okay.
Basically,
like that.
Pull the, press the button again, and it will.
I mean, for female, that's a perfect feature. Let's be honest. Also for other side, I suppose, but yeah.
Yeah. So. Put it back again, quickly, so we can go on with that. Here you got, I'm not sure if I need to tell you this, but you got your secure lock nut, and that is standard on the BMW or on this one, so people can't steal your rims. But now they know where it is, they can break the window and still steal your rims, but I would steal the whole car then. But yeah, you got your 12 volt in the back. You got some hooks where you can put some bags on it. You got even,
what's it called?
Yeah, that's a good question.
If you know how it's called, please leave a remark in the comments.
In the comments. And there you can, your dog can go up front. Pull this up and you got some more stowing places.
That's cool.
Yeah, that's cool, but I think it doesn't got a spare tire. So that's basically it.
Can you show me how to pull up the windows again?
We got We were at the keys, at the key and the features of the key. So now your car is all open and you want to close your car. You got your close button, press it and hold it, and everything will go up.
Great, thanks.
And close again, except your tailgate. So I need to close the tailgate right now. Yeah. Hilarious. It's got soft closing as well. So that's the back and the front we had. We go back. Oh, I need to open it again. Oh, about the key. BMW.
It's large.
I had a, back in the day I had a phone. It was just as big as my as the key of this car. It was a flip phone. And it's large. It's really, if you put it in your pocket, it's really, look at this. It's too large, if you ask me, but hey, that's me. Hey, welcome, Helen. How nice of you to be here and join me. So, basically inside the car, you got your cup holders, you got your ashtray. It's a non-smoker edition, if you ask me, because there's no thing inside to light your cigarettes. And I'm a non-smoker, so I don't really care. Got your parking money there, because parking in Switzerland, you have need to have some coins for it. Here you go. You got your 8-speed automatic gearbox, and I think it's a nice gearbox. It's, the lever is nice. You can shift it into manual mode, so you can shift yourself. You can do something with the settings. Eco Pro, Comfort, Sport and Sport Plus. The Sport Plus mode will shut off your traction control, so you can do some drifting, and this car will do it. And now you're thinking, but it's a X-Drive. Can you drift with the X-Drive? Well, yeah.
You proved it.
I proved it, and you can do it. Here you got your armrest with a little stowing place in it. You got your USB and AUX connections there. You can move it to the front a little bit as well and move it back again. I'm not sure for what, maybe for really small people who drive like this, but you know which people I mean, because you have seen them on the road. You're like but yeah, I don't know. You got your X-Drive or your iDrive system.
Can we show how many space I have when I sit in the back, because I have long legs.
In the back, yeah, you got show. Oh, I got one more thing to show you here in the front. If you want to turn off the system, because I don't like it when I got the whole drive, I had this thing on, you know, the radio you're listening to or the navigation system, but most of the time I know where I'm going, so I don't need the navigation system. You go to options, option is the button here, press it, and obviously this car is put in German because we live in Switzerland, and then you got your control display turning off. Press it and it shuts off.
And now you talk.
Aha, so now we're gonna show Helen, and Helen is getting into the back of the car of the BMW.
Really long legs, so.
She got some long legs and she is about 5'9", and in meters it will be 1.79 meters.
Oh,
79. And I will come a little bit closer.
This is what I was talking about in the previous video of the Nissan. Here it's even worse. I have no support for my legs. I mean, only from here I have support. Well, this is not too much, which would mean for the long road it's horrible to sit on the, in the back.
For an adult.
Yeah, because I don't have the support, and you know, I'm female, I start to complain, I'm hurting, oh my god, I don't like this.
Yeah.
Well, that's true. And but it, I can't show you the front seat.
If you drive around with a lot of adult people in the in your car, don't buy the 3 series, buy the 5 series.
And put short persons in
the and
back.
Put the small persons in the back. Here you got the front. And here it's okay.
Totally different. And you know this car, what I like, it has even extra space.
The sport seats where you can.
And this is perfect for if we drive to the Netherlands, like 8 hours in the car.
Yeah.
I mean.
8 hours.
Yeah. I drive 8 hours.
Oh, you drive 8 hours? Okay, yeah.
It's
well,
shorter.
Yeah.
Faster, really?
Yeah.
I don't. I for me it's 8 hours, and you can drive without stopping, and it's okay.
Didn't go to the Netherlands yet in this car. I did it in a Volvo S60 diesel with 160 horsepower, yeah. And I did it in 7 hours. Ooh. Now this car almost, no, not almost, got the twice the horsepower. It's got 260 horsepower, so I will be a lot faster in this car. And the great thing about the German Autobahn, the German Autobahn freeway, is you can drive fast. And
yes,
you got
the, that's correct.
Yeah.
But you must say, like in Switzerland, you can only drive 120 kilometers an hour max speed. And in Germany, it's on a lot of places the same, but they also have tracks.
Non-restricted areas.
Yes, they have.
And there you want to drive with yes. A car like this or a faster car. So, yeah.
No, I haven't heard the engine.
You haven't could heard you, the engine yet.
Could
yeah.
You be so kind to just get in the car and drive off?
Drive off.
But don't forget to pick me up, please.
I will drive off.
Okay, thanks.
Why did I bought this BMW? First of all, I like cars with a little bit of power, and the Nissan didn't do it for me. So I practically gave the Nissan to Helen and bought myself this BMW. So it's got some more horsepower, it's a little bit lower. And if you go to the Netherlands, then I got a nice car to give it some juice in Germany. On the German Autobahn. So yeah, this car will do, is limited on like 150 miles an hour. I'm not sure yet if I'm gonna do it. I have to wait because I'm still in my guarantee for the car.
I don't think that is the problem at the moment. The problem at the moment is the coronavirus.
The corona,
that you cannot
yeah,
go to the Netherlands because we have to go in quarantine.
Now, yeah, I'm not sure if I would chip tune it. I'm gonna do it in the Netherlands because we need to put it on the papers of the car. So that's some subject for another video. But it's limited on 150 miles an hour. In Germany you can do 150 miles an hour. So when the time is right and this corona thingy ends and I can go into Germany, then I will make a video of the BMW in Germany. So that's basically it. Helen got the Nissan X-Trail. I'm driving this 3 Series BMW. That are our cars. And basically this is our backyard. Got a lot of height differences here. We live in the farm down there. And it's like 700 meters above sea level. And the highest.
Yeah, I think there's a hill over there. It's in the clouds at the moment.
Yeah.
But that is about 4,200 feet.
4,200 feet?
Yes.
Oh, I'm talking in meters and you do it in feet.
Yes, of course.
I got some feet. I got 2 feet. 2 feet down there. Yeah.
So right. We can mix it all up and confuse our viewers. That's okay. So it's 1,300 meters.
1,300 meters, yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you for watching. Until next time.